the headliner for 2024. First,
let's get some energy though.
First and foremost, before we even start, we got to talk about InvestFest. Of course, we have Steve Harvey. Of course, we have Damon John, Steve Stout, T.I., Don Peebles, Lauren London, Stephen A. Smith, Monica, Earn Your Leisure, and Dunlap, 19 Keys, Pinky Cole, Shaka Bars, Van Jones, Wyclef Jean, Will I Am, Will Packer, Coach K, Yake Awaken, Billy Carson, Matthew Garland, Derek Hayes, Alex Burton, TJ, Terrence J., Kenny Burns, Larry Marl, Milan Harris, Milano, the Marathon team, Black Sam, JP, the whole team, Yandy, Poor Minds, Miss Business, Ashley, Bell, Dr. Bernice King, Dave Shands. The list goes on, right? The list goes on and on and on. And of course, we'll be having workshops on home buying, real estate investing, stock market investing for your kids, setting up your portfolio, brokerage accounts, how to advocate for your children in schools, artificial intelligence, health and wellness. Of course, we'll have 450 business vendors there and food trucks and musical performances and a VIP night and meet and greet. And you know, have, of course. But you know,
so you're saying there's more.
How it's traditionally has played out is that we've had, you know, the headliner, one or two. And you know, it's been pretty prestigious A-list people so far. Yes. that we've been able to, you know, acquire. So the standard has been set, right? So when you're on level with standard, you have to make sure that you keep standard. So we didn't announce the headliner because we were still trying to figure a few things out. So we announcing the headliner now. And, you know, to be a headliner at InvestFest, you have to kind of check off a couple different boxes. You have to be culturally relevant. Mm-hmm. It means, and this is why, unfortunately, Dan Cathy is not a headliner, right? He was at InvestFest, but nobody knew who he was. So he's worth $7 billion. But I mean, we had to tell the audience who he actually was, right? So you have to be culturally relevant. That's important. Let's not act like it's not. You have to have the business respect, right? That's also important, right? Like you just can't be culturally relevant and have no business track record. You got to have business track record. You have to be able to do it in multiple different industries. You have to be able to have the highest level of success across multiple decades. And you know, there's only a few people that fit that category, right? So with that being said, Mike, let's cue this video, man. Let's show the video.
And Sen, there it is, man. The Best Fest 2024. The lineup is officially out. It's been a stressful process, bro.
I'm glad it's over. Let's get something to eat, man.
Whoa. I hear y'all talking about the job is done.
Nah, we are done, bro.
I appreciate the help and everything, but it's over, my brother.
Trust me.
Lineup is locked.
Trust me, you're not done. Every year, InvestFest has to get bigger. This year, we got more power. This year, we get more money. This year, it's 50 times bigger.
50? Yeah.
All right, so we have the video, the trailer is done. Get rich or die.
Instead, I walk around like I got an S on my chest.
What y'all going to do now, man?
What's
shout up? Shout out to Terrence J. Shout out to Star. J. Shout out to the whole team that put this together, man. Shout out to 50. We went to Miami. We spent 3 hours with Fifth at dinner. Then we went to the club with him. And especially at dinner, we really got to have an in-depth conversation with him. And I'll tell you this much. It's going to be one of them ones, man. It's going to be one of them ones.
My boy finna talk that shit, yo.
It's going to be one of them ones. Trust me on this one.
5 hours later.
It's going to be one of them ones. Believe me. As far as he's ready to talk, he has a lot to talk about. And this is rare. He very rarely makes public appearances as far like he doesn't do Rolling Loud and stuff. Like he'll do his own tour, but he doesn't do like a lot of outside stuff. And he very rarely speaks publicly.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't really give too many interviews, but very rarely will you see 50 Cent do a public address to over 10,000 people. I don't think he's ever done that before ever. Man.
And I wonder how his grossing hip hop tours last year, right?
He definitely did.
I mean, you look at 50, somebody that's reinvented himself, like I said, since 2002, 2003, all the way now, it's 20 years in the game as far as his music career, transitioning to Hollywood, becoming the biggest in the game when it comes to, you know, the shows, of course, Power, BMF, Power Book, all of these different things that he has going on, the real estate place, taking over Louisiana, Shreveport, Louisiana.
Houston, too.
Yeah, buying up the real estate and doing, he's becoming the new Tyler Perry. You know, G-Unit Studios, he's
books,
figured it out at every single level when it comes to business. The ultimate hustler, survived the drought, you know, got shot 9 times. You know the story, like
legendary wars too.
When you're talking about surviving adversity against some of the most dangerous opponents, he's done that, and he's come out on the other side every single time. Mm-hmm. Business acumen on 1,000, cultural relevance on 1,000, never back down.
Integrity on 1,000. Yeah.
100% fearless, man.
Really like that. Like he really liked that.
Different.
And he's remember, he's sharp, man. He's sharp. So I mean, some of the conversations that we had privy to be a part of was just like I never heard him talk like that. So he's ready, man. Especially what he has brewing and some of the things that are coming up. We're gonna crack the case open, man. It's gonna be dope. I hope everybody gets to hear it and really digest this, because like you said, this is rare. I went back to YouTube to try to find an interview, and it was like he was sitting down in like a museum for like 15 minutes. I'm like, this is the only thing I found on him. So yeah, we are super super privileged to have him. Again, shout out to Sarge, shout out to TJ, shout out to everybody that made this happen. Yep. It was one of those things, man. You see us everywhere. It's for a reason. We working. We always working.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, it's one of these things where it's. How many times, right? How many times?
Come on, keep going. I'll support you.
You know, after a while, it's not luck. It's not luck. And I will say this, because this is a learning lesson. It's not luck, right? How we're able to do this year in and year out, nobody else can. They haven't figured it out. Forbes hasn't figured it out. Time magazine hasn't figured it out. Nobody has figured this out. Right. And how we've been able to figure it out. I'm gonna let you in. I'm gonna give you some game here.
Yes.
It's all about relationships. Right. And I say this all the time. And this is just the facts of, you know, cultivating a relationship with Terrence J for 4 years. This is 4 years. We didn't build a relationship with him to one day get 50 Cent. Who knew that? I didn't even know he knew 50 Cent. Right. Yeah. But it's like, you know, we have a relationship. You know, we go on vacation together. You know, we are actual friends.
Brotherhood.
Like it's an actual friendship, right? And then when the time comes for an ask, it happens, right? And he links it. And then Star, who's 50's day to day. And he's a big fan of what we got going on. And once again, that's a relationship. Him and Terrence have a relationship. He knows us from, you know, the content that we've been producing, and he's been watching it for years. And it's just a relationship thing. We go down to Miami. We have dinner with the whole team. For shout out to Barry. We have dinner with them, and we talk, and, you know, 50 talks to us, and we get the deal done. So it's like, okay, we go to Davos. That's a relationship thing. You build relationships. We go to the cons. That's the advertising week. And we're there for the whole week. And we, you know, running the Steve style and all these people. It's just, we're building relationships. And this situation, you know, we're building relationships. Robert Smith, with, you name it. Tyler Perry, Steve Harvey. So it's like, there's a reason why people go to cons. There's a reason why people go to Davos, right? And there's a reason why you should go to InvestFest. Outside of seeing some of the biggest people in the cultural history, you need to be in an environment that cultivates relationships. Like, people be like on the internet, like, well, anything that you can learn at an event, you can learn on YouTube.
No, you can't.
first of all. And second of all, you can't cultivate relationships online. Like, this is you're fighting against the information. You're watching us do it in real time, and you're trying to tell me that I don't know what I'm talking about, right? Like, you're always trying to be anti. It's like, okay, Troy tells you an option, you tell him, like, you argue with him. Ian tells you what price to buy, you argue with him. I'm telling you about how to actually cultivate relationships, and you're arguing with me. And then you're wondering why you're not moving, and the people that you're listening to, they have no track record of success. So it's like, you have to listen, you have to be humble enough to take the information and to be like, okay, well, if this is actually working for these guys, we didn't start with much. So it's like, okay, we didn't have any friendships in the music industry. We didn't have a budget. Everybody knows the story. We started with an iPhone. And over the course of 4 years, we've been able to bring you all these billionaires. And so how is this happening? Okay, this is how it's happening, right? We're cultivating relationships with people that are close to the people that are people. We're in every different environment. We go to all these different events. We're on the plane at least once a week. We're going to lunch with people. Like, okay, so
endless Zoom calls, follow up email, tech, just to check in, and nothing comes. Yeah.
So for you, right? You're on your journey to success, and success is a never ending step. Right. Yep. So it's like, you're on your journey. You can't afford not to be at the biggest business event in the world.
Yeah.
Now, that's just a fact, right? Like, why would you not go? That's my question. Unless you physically just are not able to attend. If you're able to attend and financially it's not going to crush you, why would you not put yourself in a physical environment where people are moving and shaking and trying to connect and meet people and learn information? Good things will happen to you when you put yourself in positions to win.
Mm-hmm. And I was a prime component of it. At first, I remember Troy called me one day, like, bro, you'll never pop outside. I was like, shit, I got to go to Slush.
Yeah, come on. You
got to show fit. I'm like, no, I ain't cool. I won't get COVID. He like, bro. Yeah. Can't miss the. I told my dad, hey, he's like, you got to shake hands and kiss babies. You're going to miss your moment if you don't.
And I remember that moment. You came down the steps and it was like, I knew it was an awkward situation for you, because it was like, wait, I haven't done this yet. But look at it now. Like, people, you just had
Red Panda. You can't keep me inside.
You just had Red Panda Weekend in Houston, right? Because it means something to be in front of the people. It means something when they can listen to you and they can see you on YouTube. But when they can really access you in real life, it's a different thing. That happens every single day in InvestFest throughout the weekend. It might be at a restaurant, you might run into somebody. Definitely in the vendor marketplace, you're gonna run into somebody. You might be in a lobby of your hotel, in the elevator, just by happenstance, you run into somebody. These things happen. I mean, we've said it multiple times throughout our journey. We were just walking out of an event. Oh, wait, Robert Smith is walking into us, right? Like, you have to put yourself in the position where you're gonna be able to succeed. Same thing in investing. Put yourself in position so that when times come, you're ready. You're ready prepared.
A lot of times people, you'll be able to meet your business partners, strategic partners, joint venture partners there. Even how we met, like, I got introduced to you guys to a mutual friend from somebody I was doing business with. But if he never met me in person, he wouldn't have referred me.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you have to show, people need to feel your integrity. And that's a certain je ne sais quoi that you can't fake online. You can't click funnels your way to how a person feels about you in person. You have to show up. Get your tickets.
You can meet your wife there. You can meet your husband there. You can meet. The thing about it is that, like I said, when it's crazy, like, I think Vlad has said before, like, what millionaire has gone to an event to make millions? And it's so crazy because we just came from an event with all millionaires. Yeah. We just came from an event with Steve Stout, with Carmelo Anthony, with
Elon Musk.
Saw Elon Musk there. The Kelsey brothers.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Shannon Sharp.
Every CMO of every company in the world, pretty much.
It's like, it's frustrating because these people are not either they're just misleading people with information, or they don't have the correct
or just flat out hate it.
Go to Davos, there's 15,000 people, right? 400 millionaires at an event.
NVIDIA's conference.
It's an event.
Yes.
400 billionaires came to an event. Why did they come to the event? They came to an event to learn about different things because they're in an environment with so much information being spread. It's impossible not to learn at least one thing. But more importantly, they came to actually physically meet people. Like I was talking, one of my friends works at Uber, and he was like, they just lined up meetings because they knew that there was people was going to be in cons. So it's like in cons, I'm gonna meet you at 12 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 3 o'clock. Because it's like they could have had a phone call, but they wanted to do business face to face. They wanted to meet people in person. The in person experience is never going to die. Like that's never going to be duplicated by a Zoom call, and you can't have a Zoom call with somebody that you don't know. So I say that to say there are five 20 by 20 booths left, five of them. If you're interested, there's five left. There's one 10 by 10 booth. So there's six booths left.
Which is crazy.
If you're interested in getting a booth, get your booth. It's six booths left. Okay. I'm not selling it. It's six booths left. It's going to sell itself. Get your ticket to InvestFest.
Yeah.
Friday. We have the Nipsey Hussle business grant that's still running, ladies and gentlemen. $100,000 will be given away. Let's not forget.
Mm-hmm.
Friday, all day, there will be all day education on Friday, and there will be VIP night on Friday. And then Saturday, Sunday, all day. Then there's going to be after parties. Atlanta, all the attention is going to be in Atlanta. 50 Cent, bro, you realize that this guy is probably doing business at the highest level possible for our culture right now. That's actually still talking. Because a lot of people not talking.
A lot of people not talking at all. They're done talking. Yep. Yeah. I'm done. Everybody who up Rich, they're shutting up. Nope.
Good night.
Yep. And probably won't for another 5 or 6 years.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. And so and here's another thing. So, like, on top of it, is like the people at that level, especially at 50, which is very few, he let us in on some conversation of the people he's talking to who are actually giving him guidance. Yeah. So, I mean, that's incredible, man. I'm excited.
And like you said, even how he structured that deal, like when if you get him to reveal that, how he structured that deal, I'm like, that's fucking genius. What?
Yeah.
And my thing, everybody who goes to InvestFest, if you learn one thing from every speaker and you meet 10 people, you should be able to 10x your business.
At least. I met somebody yesterday. I just started a trucking company. He's talking about he was at InvestFest. He was talking to somebody. And we actually have a trucking panel this year. Shout out to Alex.
Mm-hmm.
So literally every single day I meet somebody that's like, yo, InvestFest changed my life.
Yep.
Da, 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 da. So InvestFest is August 23rd in Atlanta, Georgia.
Cannot wait.
Get your tickets, get your hotel rooms.
Yes,
before
please.
They sell out. There's please. A hotel that's attached to Georgia World Congress Center. They just built it. So you don't even have to leave your hotel. You can literally walk from your hotel to convention hall.
It's connected.
There's a hotel block, which is a discounted rate. That's on the website. So when you buy a ticket, you can get a hotel for a discounted rate also.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, what you want me to do?
And you should probably say through that following Monday. So for whatever business you didn't get done on Sunday, meet with people on Monday, close the deal while you're there. Because if you all wait till y'all go back home, the deal's not going to be done.
Close the deal. Close the deal.
Don't leave till you close something.
Close the deal.
All right. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Shout out to 50. Once again, shout out to 50. Shout out to Star. Shout out to Terrence J. Man.
Yeah.
Incredible. I cannot wait.
That was that Miami scene was a whole, that's a documentary in itself. that whole process, man. But we got it done.
And you get the recording. If you buy an InvestFest ticket, you get the recordings of old InvestFest. So I mean, there's really no reason. It's $250, ladies and gentlemen. Like, come stop. On,
yo.
You spent that on a pair of Jordans.
A few times.
Over and over again.
Three times.
At least. And if you live in Atlanta, the last thing I'll say is this. If you live in Atlanta, North Carolina, greater area, that greater 3 mile radius, 3 hour radius.
Yeah, Florida. We counting y'all.
Yeah.
100,000% no reason why you shouldn't be. Look.
Yeah.
Shout out to Lotto. She just sold out her birthday bash.
Yeah, 16,000.
16,000 people. Salute. Chris Brown, I heard he's going to have to do 3 shows in Atlanta because he couldn't. One show was. Don't talk to me about ticket pricing. You're spending money to get entertained at unprecedented levels. unprecedented levels. And shout out to all of them. I'm not hating on them. I salute them. But don't ever say you can't invest in your education when I know for a fact you're investing in your entertainment. So if entertainment is more important than education, just say that. I'd rather you just say that, because I've never heard any complaints about Chris Brown tickets, Beyonce tickets, Lotto birthday bash tickets, Usher. Y'all flew to Vegas.
I've seen ya.
For 97 weeks. He did a residency for 3 years.
Some of y'all fellas buying a meet and greet for Chris Brown to Chris Brown enrolling your girl.
Let me take the picture for you.
What? No, you take the picture of your girl while I grab her ass. What? Y'all see me.
Yeah, honey. I'll take the picture.
This street's wicked.
That boy on the breakup tour.
Wicked.
For real. For 1,111? Boy.
Yeah. Let me hug up on your girl for 1,100.
All right. And by the way, the last thing I'll say is we're not done.
Oh, yeah.
Stay tuned.
Oh, yeah. By the way.
Don't message me and ask me who. I don't know. See?
Nah,
I don't
know more to play come. Work. More to come. This is the year.
Pre-sale tickets end soon.
This is the year.
Pre-sale tickets end soon.
And y'all lucky I don't get them to, because if it was just me running it, it'd be $250 an hour.
For real. The per panel play.
Boy.
Check in per panel. okay, ladies and gentlemen.